If there's one name as legendary to fighting games as Ryu or Terry, it's Ken. Ken Masters is Ryu's longtime rival in the Street Fighter series and one of the second most recognizable faces in fighting games. Ken is one of the first examples of an Echo fighter in fighting games, and one of the first examples of the brash, fiery American counterpart trope in Japanese media. For the quick lore, Ken and Ryu both trained under the same master and seek to prove themselves the strongest fighters. They're both your typical good, virtuous dudes looking for an even battle. For the quick Smash lore, Ken trained harder coming into Ultimate and is faster and better in the current meta than Ryu, so most serious competitors play Ken instead of Ryu. In a game with all sorts of wild, world-famous characters, why pick up Ryu and Ken anyways? They're just two buff dudes. Not a fire-breathing turtle or a sassy hair witch or a soul-devouring fitness trainer. But appearances can be deceiving. Ken might seem like the most normal dude fighter on the cast, but his mechanics make him super unique. And strangely, so does his realism. Ken inherited a more realistic style from Street Fighter, and it gives him this nice oomph few other characters have. The sounds his hits make have a real texture that lots of Nintendo's cartoony characters lack. And the visuals, oh man, there's nothing like watching the staggered multi-hits of a heavy Shoryuken connecting into each other. So Ken is the character to pick up if you want a unique character with a lot of oomph. And not just in terms of visuals, in terms of gameplay too. Unless you want to pick up Hiro and just have it spelled out for you, but can't go wrong. Ken has some of the most satisfying combos and kill confirms in Smash. Every opening you get feels meaningful, each punish feels big, and one hit means another. If that sold you, then it's time to hit the dojo and take your first steps to becoming a Ken Master. But if you're looking for other guides, information about other characters, or live coaching, then look at ProGuides.com. ProGuides.com has even more courses to help you step up your game, including ones taught by legendary pros like MKLeo and ESAM. Now let's get started on this martial arts journey. And we mean it when we say get started. It's always tempting to jump into the deep end of the pool right away, but that's not the best way to learn how to swim. It's just the best way to get the lifeguard's attention and embarrass yourself at a public pool. So let's start with those basic necessities, the simple things you need to know to play Ken. First up, you gotta learn the language of the traditional 2D fighter. Not just inputs, but notation and light, medium, and heavy attacks too. Let's start with notation and inputs. In Smash, you unlock different combos through precise movements. It's all about fast falls, short hops, and spacing. Ken comes from a traditional fighter where you unlock combos through precise inputs done by moving the stick a certain way in a certain time window. So, to unlock Ken's full potential, you gotta know those precise Smash movements and those precise Street Fighter inputs. If that sounds hard, it's because it is. Ken is one of Smash's toughest characters to play, let alone master. But this guy's loyal. Stick by him, and he'll reward you with wins. To describe inputs better, we've got notation. Notation gives numbers to your stick directions. Here's what it looks like, courtesy of Mufin over at Super Jump Magazine. 6 is always facing the opponent, forward, while 4 is always facing away from the opponent, backward. You should also know the terms quarter circle and half circle, which are what they sound like. Quarter circle is when you move the joystick around one quadrant or corner of the circle. So, 236 is a forward quarter circle and 214 is a backward circle. A half circle is just two quadrants or corners, so 41236 for a forward half circle and 63214 for a backwards half circle. These inputs will cause Ken to do certain specials or unique moves. That means Ken gets more moves than a lot of the cast, but to unlock them, you gotta know inputs. You can also cast his neutral, side, and up special using inputs, and if you do, they'll deal extra damage and knockback. So start thinking of that joystick as an arcade stick and learn those inputs. Here's a quick breakdown of Ken's 5 command inputs. For some of you, this might be a lot to take in, so feel free to pause the video or slow it down or whatever you need to do to make sure you get these inputs down. 236 or quarter circle forward equals your neutral special, Hadouken. 63214, half circle back, equals your side special, Tatsu. 623 or forward down down forward equals your up special. That legendary Shoryuken! 632 or quarter circle down equals a unique normal crescent kick. And 41236 or half circle forward equals the other unique normal roundhouse kick. On top of all that, if you hold A after a crescent or roundhouse kick, you'll do an Inazuma kick. In simple terms, the Inazuma kick is an additional hit after the crescent or roundhouse kick. It'll make the input do more damage and knockback. So it can be good at low percents to do more damage, but it could be bad at certain percents because it knocks the opponent out of range for a better follow-up. That's the basic rundown for inputs. You can play Ken without using inputs, but those inputs are necessary to unlock Ken's full damage, combo, and kill potential. So if you're picking up Ken, put that time into practicing inputs. Now that you know about inputs, almost all inputs and moves have light, medium, and heavy variations. Light inputs do less knockback and damage, heavy does more. To do a light input, quickly tap whatever button you're pressing. To do a medium input, quickly double tap the button. To do a heavy input, hold the button down. This technique isn't physically difficult, it's more something you just have to keep in mind. Certain moves like down tilt will combo in light form, but not in heavy form. Certain moves like Shoryuken will kill in heavy form, but not in light form. If you don't keep light, medium, and heavy button presses in mind, you might drop a kill confirm or combo. So you got those inputs down, and now you're wondering how to use them. This is where the game plan comes in. Every character has an archetype and a game plan. For example, Fox is a rushdown character who wants to chase down his opponents and combo them. Ken is the bait and punish brand of rushdown character. Ken's not as fast as Fox and doesn't have the same tools to just run up on characters. He's got better tools for baiting opponents to hit him than punishing them when they miss. Like in Street Fighter, Ken will always turn to face his opponent. That's super helpful for whiff punishing because it means Ken doesn't have to turn around after backdashing away from a move. That's important because it gives Ken access to all his great forward-facing moves. Other characters would have to turn around, wasting valuable frames or use backward-facing options. Better yet, all of Ken's moves have quick startup, especially in Light variant. Light down tilt has just 2 frames of startup. That's 2/60ths of a second. That means Ken's move will usually hit faster and beat other moves. When an opponent misses, Ken can respond with a super quick retaliation. Most of Ken's moves are good at baiting and punishing, it just depends on how their character is approaching. If they whiff a grounded attack and are further away, medium forward tilt or heavy down tilt could punish. If they whiff a ground move and they're right in your face, it's time to call your mom and tell her about how you just won your first Smash tournament. But seriously, this is one of Ken's favorite situations, and you can respond with a down tilt, heavy jab, or an up tilt. These moves alone don't do a ton. Light down tilt doesn't even do 2%, but they all have so little knockback that you get follow-ups even at high percents. For example, at low percents, you can get 2 down tilts and a special like Tatsu or Shoryuken. Both give you a lot of stage control. Tatsu carries your opponent into the corner. Shoryuken launches your opponent up into a juggle state, or just kills them. You can also do 2 heavy jabs into a special. Light up tilt generates combos at higher percents, like light up tilt into dare at above 80%, or light up tilt into forward smash, which will kill at high percents. If your opponent whiffs an aerial approach, then neutral air tends to be the best punish. Neutral air combos into lots of things at lots of percentages. If you chase their landing, you can often follow up with down tilts, then a special. If you chase them in the air at lower percents, you can get another neutral air. Up air can combo into itself and other moves too, as well as lead to a Shoryuken, but it's got a small hitbox that's only gonna hit opponents up and in front of you. Forward air is a good way to knock an aggressive opponent back, but doesn't lead to as much. To boil it down, as Ken, you want to dodge, retaliate with a light combo starter or two, then cap it all off with a heavy move or special like Tatsu, Shoryuken, or Crescent or Roundhouse Kick. But you won't always find aggressive opponents who are constantly attacking and missing. Plenty of opponents will push Ken to approach. This is where Ken's great shield pressure comes into play. Lots of Ken's moves will pin an opponent in their shield because they have lots of shield stun and they're fast. They can't drop their shield as quickly when Ken hits it, and if they do drop shield, they need to have a super fast option ready or they'll get hit. Ken can't just use any move to pressure shields though. Landing with an aerial on a shield will usually get Ken punished, as would hitting a shield with something like a smash attack or poorly spaced forward tilt. However, Ken's up-close attacks like up tilt, heavy jab, crescent kick, and roundhouse kick will make it hard for opponents to drop their shield. Ken even has good shield break setups like light up tilt into heavy up tilt into roundhouse kick into Inazuma. This is where the game plan gets interesting. That shield pressure encourages opponents to knock Ken away with preemptive hits. Ken can then bait those preemptive hits out with his approach, then hit the opponent after they miss. If opponents are walling you out well or finding gaps in your shield pressure, you can also use Tatsu after hitting their shield to spin behind them. Some characters won't be able to close the distance and counterattack very well. Okay. That's just the very start to Ken. Seriously, the Shoto characters in Smash are a lot of work. But even then, we have a lot more to go on Ken. So far, we've reviewed the controls for Ken with the numeric notation and FGC system of inputs and your general game plan for Ken. However, we're not done, and you can learn more over at ProGuides.com. You'll find more on our Ken guide with how to ultimately take stocks from your opponents, how to recover and stay alive, and most importantly, how to win as Ken. You can find that video on our website right now, and you can also find plenty more free content here on our YouTube channel. Go ahead and subscribe right now. Don't ever doubt your skill in Smash and think you won't make it far in bracket, because the answer with Pro Guides is always going to be 6-2-3, sure you can.
Oh, thank God I'm getting paid for saying this pun to death.
Anyways, we'll catch you next time here on Pro Guides.